This is actually my revenue growth. Can you all see this okay? This chart might take a little bit of a lag, but this is where I started. I started the firm in generally like right around June 2016. I resigned from my position in January to February 2016, but I gave them about 6 month transition time. So I really left in June. And it wasn't until was it February of 2018? On February 11th of 2018, I decided to hire 3 full-time staff people and 1 executive assistant. And the executive assistant was purely for consistency in the marketing. Up until that point, I lost a big client here. But up until that point, I was basically not doing marketing consistently. I was not taking on work because I had it in my mind. I couldn't take on more work. I had all kinds of stuff going on in my brain that would include fear of not being able to deliver on the work, fear that I'm already busy enough, that how can I possibly take on more work, fear of not staying true to myself, meaning I left my job in an effort to find a better balance with my family specifically, because my daughter was 1 at the time. And if I took on more work or I grew this big business, then that means I would have less time, which would be like not true to who I am. I mean, all kinds of things like fear of like being a sellout. It was a new identity I had to basically, accept of myself, because where I came from, you know, I come from like blue collar working families and my friends are all that way. And so it was really weird. It was like an identity crisis almost that I was kind of going through. And it wasn't until January of 2019. Can you see this graph?
Yes.
January of 2019, I decided, okay, I'm going to take this thing to the next level. Because I started to get this point where I'm like, I don't know what's going on. When I talk to you guys about the dark place that I was in December of 2018, I'm like, what am I doing with my life? I fired another person while on the plane, December 2018. I don't know how long you've been part of the group, but that was a CFO boot camp. So I did a presentation there. I was like exhausted. I had like the stomach flu or something. I was up there. You guys didn't know that. I had like anti-nausea medication going on. And I'm like, I'm so exhausted about, you know, what's going on with my life. How do I do this? But prior to that, May, that's when I bought the truck, the infamous truck story that Andrew and I talk about, where I went to Tahoe and Andrew's like, get your life together, stop meandering. Because up until that point, I had been kind of like, when I say I really started to take my business serious after that event, this was the point where Andrew said, you need to make some tough decisions. So I fired my largest client right here at the time. I fired my brother. I decided to re-engineer the entire business and I bought that expensive truck that, you know, we still have. And from that point, things just started taking off. And then it's like, oh my God, what's going on? What's going on? How am I going to do all of this? And I knew that there had to be a way. And I knew that the way was to grow, because I wouldn't be able to, because I was struggling even before then, like I'm getting too busy for myself and all this sort of stuff. So then December 2018, I just got really angry and you could go back and watch the videos from that CFO bootcamp. You could tell, like, I just got tired of like being tired and all of these things. So that's when I was sitting on the plane on the flight back, landing in a blizzard in the middle of St. Louis. I remember I said, I'm just going to hire everybody. I'm going to hire as many people as I can find, right, that I can afford. And so I hired 3 staff accountants and 1 executive assistant, and they started in February, right? So I knew I made the decision in January to hire them, and I signed a lease January 2nd. I moved into my office. So you can imagine January 2018 to January 2019, I'm like, world, I'm available. I'm willing. I'm able. I'm open to this. I signed a lease on an office space that I didn't even have employees hired yet. I started interviewing, and you could see the trajectory of growth, you know, at that particular point. And so then I ended up hiring them in February. And why is that important? Because in January and February, psychologically, I said, oh my God, I've just committed to a lot. So I need to be really consistent with sales in order to keep pace with the growth that now I've basically now committed us to. So that was the executive assistant. And that goes back to my initial point with you. Since that time, I've always invested in some situation where my business can have consistent marketing, consistent campaigning, consistent, you know, sales. Every single week, I'm accountable to bringing in strategy sessions. And you can see the trajectory from that point when I made that decision, right? In May of 2018, I'm going to do this thing and I'm going to be consistent and I'm going to figure out a way to make it happen. And then really, I didn't really have the team yet, but I knew in my mind I had committed to it. So starting at this point, on up, I mean, you could see when you commit to sales and marketing and you've committed to the growth, it just explodes.